Hey there, welcome to today's video. My name is Courtney.
Excuse you, sir.
My cat just sneezed. I hope you are having a fantastic day. Okay, so a few videos ago, I really don't remember how many videos ago it was now. We're about to have a friend. Hello, sir. Hi, how are you? Welcome. How's it going? I was gonna say it was like a few videos back, but I feel like it was definitely more than a few videos now. My friend Marta and I were talking about how there are so many of these filled ropes coming out now. I've done a bunch of different ones, reviewed a bunch of different ones so far, and today's video is literally full of ropes. These ones are all bites. They're all specifically bite-sized ones that I have not tried yet. So I don't know if just like one brand started it and another hopped on the train, or people just mass talked about it. Everyone's like, we're gonna compete and see who can come up with the best one. I don't know. But all I know is that there are a lot of these new filled ropes, whether they're full ropes or, in today's video, all four of them just happen to be bites and bite size. So let's just jump right into it. Okay, so first up are from the brand Haribo, and these ones are sour bites. They say zing. I'm not really sure if that has much to do with it, but they're two flavors in one. Let's see. All right, the flavors are strawberry lemon, lime lemon, watermelon red raspberry, and blue raspberry red raspberry. That's interesting that they have like lemon is in two of the flavors and red raspberries in two of the flavors. That's interesting. All right. Positive sign, the bag smells good. Wow, okay. So the flavors are super, super good. I would say they're about a medium sour level, and they're not super sour, but they're definitely, like, there's definitely a good sour kick to them. The blue ones are by far my favorite. Those are so good. They have a good amount of the coated sugary stuff on them, which is what gives it the sour. These are fantastic. My only negative is I wish they were a little bit softer. They are a bit on the chewy side, but I am thoroughly impressed. There's no weird artificial flavor to it. These are fantastic. These are going to be dangerous as well. Okay, so next up, these are Airheads Soft Filled Bites. Okay, so these ones don't say sour on them, but on the back they do say three dimensions of tangy, sweet, and smooth flavor. And the flavors are blue raspberry, watermelon, orange, cherry, and strawberry. Okay, so in comparison, these ones are okay. They're good. The blue, the green, the red and the pink all pretty much taste like their counterpart Airheads, with just a bit of a like sour sugar sprinkling on them. So it's nice because it has that addition, so it's definitely different. But they're a bit on the tough side. They're a bit chewy, not very soft. And I think that takes away from it a bit because you almost have to work to get at it. I think I like regular Airheads better because they have a bit more flavor to them. Not that these don't, but they're almost too small that it's hard to get a good grasp on the flavor. But I do really like that it has the sour coating. I wish if it had more of a sour coating and they were a little bit softer, these would knock it out of the park and be absolutely fantastic. The orange, actually, now that I think about it, the orange is probably the flavor of Airheads I've had the least in my lifetime. So there's actually a good chance it tastes a lot more similar to it than I realized, because it's probably been a while. But the rest of them taste fairly similar, which is like a fun outer coating. They're just the toughness. It's almost a bit much. But they're good. If you like Airheads, if you love Airheads and you like sour things, I would recommend trying these. Okay, so next up, these are Sweetarts Rope Bites in Twisted Mixed Berry. Chewy outside, soft inside. And we also love a resealable bag. Okay, so I made a face in the beginning because so far those are hands down the softest of all of the bites. They are super, super soft. I put them on like a medium level of sourness, but the flavor, it's not there. Like, it's okay, it's not bad, but it's not great. The first two that I've tried so far, the Airhead and the Haribo, They did a really nice job with the flavors, so this just feels like it falls flat in comparison. But the inside is where it takes the cake, because the inside of the sweet tart rope, so if you've ever had, maybe that's where everybody else kind of got the idea and was like, we need to get on this with the sweet tart ropes. If you've ever had those, I've reviewed some of them in the past, and it has this really interesting tart, soft inside that I don't even know how to, like, it almost reminds me of the texture of icing, but I know that it's not. So that makes this unique and different on its own. So if they were to have the inside of this with the Haribo flavors, those would be amazing. But these are just okay. It's probably like least favorite so far, but like also not awful, you know? Okay, last, but also most definitely not the least, because if you've watched any of my videos before, I like to save what I'm hoping is going to be the best for last. So these are Jolly Rancher Bites. Awesome twosome. I don't really know what that means. Okay, I think it's interesting that they're promoting twosomes here on their bags of Jolly Ranchers, but they have two flavors for each of them. So there are cherry orange and watermelon green apple. I'm kind of sad there's only two flavors in here. I didn't realize that until just now. But let go. Okay, so pros. Same level of softness as the sweet tart ones. They're super, super soft, and especially the outside, they're really nice. They're definitely a bit on the sour scale. I would say like medium level. Like, I would think the only thing that really wasn't that sour at all would be the sweet tart rope bites, where the other three had a nice sour kick to them, with the Haribo and the Jolly Rancher being like the most sour. But sadly, I did not find the cherry orange one, the one with the orange in the center, I did not find to taste like a Jolly Rancher at all, and I really wasn't loving it. And then the watermelon green apple one, the green apple on the inside tastes most definitely like a Jolly Rancher and is really, really good. But the outside is, oh, it's not the same. Okay, one's cherry and one's watermelon, but they both have some sort of like off-putting artificial flavor to them that makes them just not great. Like, had they used pure Jolly Rancher flavoring and not whatever, there's something in the gummy part of it that is probably, it's probably just part of whatever the gummy base is, that is a bit off-putting. Maybe it's a sweetener of some sort, I'm not sure. But I don't love it. The inside is okay, the aftertaste is okay. So if I could like sit there and pick out from the bag just the ones with the green on the inside. Like, if I eat any more of these, that is what, if I eat any more of these, that is what I'm going to do. I will pick out just the ones with the green on the inside, because I don't find the other ones necessarily worth it in comparison, but that's just me, I'm weird. Okay, so final thoughts. Is it a little weird that so many companies have come out with their own filled bites, sour bites, filled ropes, sour ropes, whatever it is, in the past like year? A little bit. If you have any like theories, or you actually know of a reason that might have been like a thing, or why it's all of a sudden like the rage where everyone came out with their own version, let me know in the comments. I would love to know any thoughts and theories. If you've got like any wild, insane, crazy theories, and you just want to go for like a trip and like give me like some crazy ass theory, I would love to hear it. Please entertain me. That would be great. But yeah, so that is it. If I'm going to recommend any, I would 100% recommend the Haribo ones. It's funny, I like to try to save the best for last, and this time I ended up having the best first, which is funny because I thought Haribo was going to be my least favorite, and that is why I had it first. So joke's on me, I guess. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you so much for watching. And I will see you in the next one, which is going to be cool. It is a Colombian candy taste testing video. I'm very excited. I found it at a local candy store, and I'm very excited to give it a try. So I will see you in that one. And in the meantime, I hope you have a great week, and I will see you next week. Bye.